Where are we locally in the fight against COVID right now?
Yeah, where we're seeing that second surge, you know, not only here, but all across the state, we've sort of had stable high numbers for about 2 weeks now. So we're sitting about 180, 190 within our system. And if you look at the other systems, they're at their high numbers. That's our highest numbers. And we're staying right at that point.
How old are they? How sick are they? And has this changed over the last few months?
Yeah. It's so variable, Neil. That's what's so weird about this disease. We did have one couple that got admitted that one was 75 and one was 95. And the one that did best was the 95. But not everybody's the same. We see some people where we think are going to be very sick. And they're not.
How close are you to running out of beds at this point?
Well, we have beds. We just don't have enough staff. And so we actually have some traveling nursing, mainly nursing staff that have started last week and this week, which has been helpful, especially in the ICU. We're close. You know, we watch beds every day. We're not turning away patients. We're seeing many patients sent to us from smaller hospitals, Neil, where they can't take care of them. So many of our patients are not from Forsyth County. They're from counties around here that are being sent to us. And there's no choice. We need to take them and take care of them in the best way we can.
Wake Forest Baptist, the first medical center in North Carolina to receive a shipment. We all remember the video of Dr. Ohl getting the first shot. Have all of your eligible staff members been vaccinated?
Almost. The latest numbers today are 8,652, and they're primarily, high percentage of frontline staff, those that are involved with the COVID-19 virus, whether they're working with it or testing it or seeing patients. We have 200 that have gotten their second dose already, which is great to do it.
Within the last week, Wake Forest Baptist started offering vaccines to a small group of its patients, 75 and older. What qualifications do these patients have that make them eligible to receive the shot?
We utilize one of our clinics because we have a stick clinic for the aging. So patients were coming into the clinic anyway, and we offered them the vaccine so that we could register them and follow them. We wanted to see how that worked. And you'll see us start vaccinating more patients 75 and older throughout the region as we go forward.
What kind of hope do you have to offer at this point that will help our community get through this?
We got the vaccine in record time, and we know that we'll be able to get people vaccinated, get on the other side of this so that we can make it happen. When I went down there, I was helping give vaccines right before Christmas because, the Christmas time was really hard to get vaccines because people were in and out. So I was drawing up the vaccines so they could give them. I tell you, the people coming in getting the vaccine had such a sense of hope. I mean, it almost felt like we had a vaccine cocktail party. I mean, one, wow. We don't go anywhere anymore, but the energy and the enthusiasm for those getting their vaccine and going on the other side was amazing. So even getting your vaccine can be a very wonderful experience.